What is up, cool kids? My name is Gavin, I'm back, cool trainer, back at you again for some more Wi-Fi battles. So last time we went 2-0, it was 1-2, and it was the start of the new battle season, at least for us, so we are a little under 1500, not really where I want to be, but we used a different team. This team we are going for this team, so we see, Wikiberry, Wishy Washy, Draconium Z, Drapa, Assault Vest Garchomp, Life Orb Mimikyu, Leftovers Tapu Fini, and Aipapa Berry, if that's even how you say it, whatever that berry is, Sableye. So, we see some potential physical threats. Obviously the Gyarados, which is probably Mega. The Lurantis can be either, but is probably outside of the Sun, is probably physical. Kumo-O can be either, but you usually see it special, so I don't know. So I'm not feeling Sableye right now. I'm liking Drapa. And Garchomp and Mimikyu. So I'm going to lead. I'm not going to lead Drapa. I'm going to lead Garchomp, bring Mimikyu, and bring Drapa third. So the reason that I didn't lead Drapa is because of the Sylveon. Because I would just turn one. Draconium Z, Draco Meteor. But the risk of that Sylveon being there and switching into that is not what I want. Okay, so we do see the Gyarados, which is bad news bears for me. Because it probably carries Ice Fang, Dragon Dance, Waterfall, and Earthquake. With Mold Breaker, Rex Mimikyu. So I'm going to switch to Drapa, because we can at least paralyze it, Garchomp can come back in and take care of it. I keep smelling ramen in my room from somewhere, and like I really don't know where. Like, I had ramen like 3 days ago, but I don't even have a microwave in my room, so it's not like I made it here. So he read that like a book. So do we glare? Are we that real? He's not gonna wanna stay in. Or no, he's not gonna wanna switch out. Do I think a plus one Ice Fang will kill? Is the real question. I'm gonna risk it. It's battle one, I'm gonna risk it. We're going Devastating Drake right now. I don't think it'll kill, but it should pop as long as we don't flinch. If we flinch, I'm gonna lose it. Hot dog. Alright, so Gyarados should be gone. Look at those eyebrows. Look at them. That is an angry snake dragon thing. Like, what is Drapa even, like, supposed to be? Like, most of the dragons are pretty obvious that they're based on something. Like, Garchomp is, like, a shark. Salamence is a European dragon. Rayquaza is a Chinese dragon. But, like, what is Drapa? Like, I really don't understand. So I don't know what he would want to do right now. He might go to the Sylveon. So here I'm going to try and paralyze it. It's probably just going to KO me right here, which Drapa did his job. So good work, Drapa. So now I am going to... I'll take a look at the rest of his team, and like, can't. Okay, so we are Assault Vest Garchomp, so I do think we can take a Moonblast. However, I think I want to save Garchomp, so I'm going to go into Mimikyu. So, pretty standard, we are going to Swords Dance, turn one. And we see that we outspeed, so I don't need to Shadow Sneak. Mimikyu is so good. Okay, so I am going to Shadow Claw, because I think that will take it out, because its defense is trash. Okay, so we're starting off pretty well this episode. So who else did he bring? I don't know what's taken him so long. I mean, he's only got one Pokemon left. He's probably gonna DC, honestly. Vikavolt. So, that's the game, because we have Garchomp. But this shiny Vikavolt is easily, like, top three shinies for me. Like, number one's Rayquaza, because look at it. Number two? Number two, I would have to say, is probably Mega Gengar. Because I just love how it goes from, like, standard Gengar, where you can't really tell, to Mega Gengar being, like, pure white, and I love it. And then number three, Vikavolt. Ooh, that didn't pick up the KO, so that's going to Flash Cannon. I forgot it got Flash Cannon. But it doesn't matter, because we have Garchomp, so we can just come in and Dragon Claw. That's something that I've been working on getting, is a good Vikavolt. I've got a couple Modest Grubbins. I don't think that they're fully IV'd, so I need to keep breeding. But I also am debating on whether I want to make them quiet instead of modest to go for a full Trick Room tune, because Vikavolt's HP is decent. But Vikavolt's speed, everything in Gen 7 speed is trash, really. And a quiet lower speed, so for a Trick Room team, that would be pretty decent. Because it's not going to outspeed very much anyway. So we are starting off strong this episode. So what? I need to make a good team for the battle tree, so that we can get some new music, because I have not done any of that yet. Wow, that was fast. So 1581 from Japan. Ooh, that team is trouble. So, that team is a lot of trouble. I'm liking a Sableye lead right now. Because the only thing that really bothers it is the Mimikyu. So I'm feeling Sableye, Garchomp, and Wishiwashi. I like that. Because we have Ice Beam on Wishiwashi for the Garchomp, we have Hydro Pump for the Arcanine, we have Knock Off on Sableye for the Porygon 2. Or I don't have much for that Theramosa. Outside of Garchomp being assault vested and living a bug buzz, I mean, you don't really need much for a Theramosa, you just need to be able to live a hit. So, Sableye lead, Garchomp, and Wishy Washy. Okay, so I'm predicting the Theramosa lead. Mimikyu. Oh no. Now, do you turn one? Do you turn one player off me? Are you that real? I don't think you're that real. So I'm going to Willow. I probably should have taunted, though. I probably should have taunted. He's afraid. I'm down with that. That's fine with me. Oh, no. Now it gets priority recovers. Alright. So now I'm gonna knock off. Or do I taunt? I'm gonna knock off. I can taunt next turn. My thought with taunting was that I don't want him to get a Trick Room set up. Man, she's really thinking. She's thinking hard. So Ice Beam, we are specially defensive. So once we get frozen, we can even take another one of those. So I'm going to taunt. So that it cannot recover, and then switch out onto probably Wishy-Washy. Because even with Assault Vest, Garchomp does not want to take an Ice Beam. So he's really, she is really thinking, she's thinking hard. So they're trying to paralyze me, and they do it. But we get our berry to pop, which is great. So when we come back in after, so we're going to switch to Wishy-Washy this turn. So am I real enough to predict that he's going to go for Discharge again and go into Garchomp? Or do I predict the Ice Beam and go to Wishy-Washy? I think you'd go for an Ice Beam. Because I want to say, I'm not positive, I want to say Discharge is only 80 base power. And Ice Beam is 90, so I'm going to go to Wishy-Washy. Freeze us. Cool. Okay, so it's still taunted. Does anything on his team want to take a Hydro Pump? Not one thing. Okay. So assuming we land the Hydro Pump, this thing's blown away. It outspeeds, but we're fine. Ooh. We ate that up. Look at that giant mouth. Just eats up the discharge. Eats it up. Alright. So, it's got the Mimikyu still. And Garchomp? Maybe? Okay, so what I am gonna do, I'm gonna U-turn just to break the thing. So I don't want to risk. I probably should have went for Ice Beam, hoping for a freeze. He's real. All right. That's actually better for me, to be honest, because he doesn't have a Swords Dance up. So I'm going to Sableye. Now, he probably thinks that I am going to want to Will-O-Wisp him, because that's what I did the first time. So this time, instead, I'm going to Taunt. Solid. Alright. So now we are going for Will-O-Wisp, because I kind of have to. Because if I go for knockoff, I will be... Arceus is real. Arceus is real. Alright. That's so bad. We live! Alright, so now we can recover stall. Do we taunt again? Because the... The thing is, the disguise is not broken. So Garchomp does not win against that thing. So I'm going to recover. Actually, do I think he's going to go for a Swords Dance, or do I think he's just going to try and kill me? If I think he's going to go for a Swords Dance, I might as well go for a knockoff. I'm going to go for the knockoff. Okay, so that's payback for that player off missing. So now I have to recover. We still have our berry, don't we? That was the only thing I could do. So I think we lost. I know that the burn and the plus two kind of negate each other, so I don't think a standard play rough will take us out, but he still has another Pokemon. So I am going to just Earthquake. A decent battle. Very long battle. Oh, well. That was a good game. So right now we are 1-1 today. So let's see if we can reverse last time and go 2-1. Oh, bad at music. I'm going for it. Enter the Ultra Beast. I'm super excited. I saw this in Walmart the other day, and just, I had to get it. Because it's one of my favorite... Oh, we see some Extreme Evo Boost shenanigans for sure. So I'm going to lead Sableye to taunt, so it cannot Baton Pass on us. And I like having Burn on this team anyway for that Scizor, the Garchomp. And having Taunt for the Ninetales. In case it wants to do any Aurora Veil stuff. And also Taunt for the... Sableye just does very well against this team in general. So I'm leading Sableye. I'm also liking Garchomp. Actually, no, I'm not liking Garchomp. So I'm going to bring Tapu Fini. And do I want Mimikyu? Or do I want Wishy Washy? I want Drapa, actually. Because we know Flamethrower for the Ninetales. Thunderbolt for the Toxapex. And we can paralyze stuff. Anyway, I saw some Walmart, had to buy it. And I love how it's got the little tail, like, just, like, peeking out the side. Cause, like, this is supposedly the actual Wobbuffet, is the tail. But I love Wobbuffet so much, I had to buy it. So we see the Ninetales lead. The Ninetales lead, not great for us. So the best thing, I could switch out into Fini. That would be pretty decent, because even Freeze Dry isn't going to do a whole lot, because we're a Tapu Fini, we're especially defensive. But I'm going to stay in. No, Sableye's too valuable to sack off like that. So I am going to switch to Tapu Fini. And first turn set up Knock Worry. Because we have Leftovers and Protect. So when Tapu Fini is on the field, it does not leave. That's why I love Tapu Fini. Should have taunted, but I mean, that's going to go away in a couple turns anyway. So even a freeze, I use Protect on accident, but you know what, that's fine. It burns a turn of the Aurora Veil, so that's fine. And I also run Toxic, which isn't very conducive for the Misty Terrain, because it prevents status. He's real. He is that real. Okay. So we just entered emergency mode. This one needs to go now. I am going to set up the Aqua Ring. Because I don't think Sheer Cold will... He lands it. Okay, he lands it. That's fine. That's fine. Thank you. I need more coffee after that. Okay. So, we're going with Drapa. What? It lands a sheer cold. That's wild. I mean, I shouldn't really talk because I run Fissure on my Gastrodons. But I'm going to Flamethrower. So the Aurora Veil is still up, so this is not going to take it out. That was a wild battle. I cannot. Like, did that actually just happen? I misplayed turn one on that. So yeah, I'm just gonna run. Cause like what? I've never, on camera, never landed one of my Fissures on my BGC matches with my Gastrodon. First sheer cold. First sheer cold lands. What a way to end the episode. So we are now 2-4. Our rating is probably in the 1470s. Alright, so that's gonna wrap up this episode. I still cannot believe that just happened. If you enjoyed this video as much as I did, please like and or subscribe. Any comments, advice, sets that you want to see me try out, drop those down in the comments below. And until next time, smiley later.